thing is happening in this evening. You know? No, that's true, you know. That is what your faces look like. What are you going to learn today? Oh my God, what is this? Oh, what the hell? Something like that lah. Okay, now open your data set. So we are going to run a simple linear regression. Simple, eh? That's why I need to address simple. Don't ask the multiple lah. Ask simple first. So next time, if we organize multiple regression, the first after you register, we will test this one. If you not pass, no lah, just kidding. No, otherwise you are feel very ni lah, very upset lah because you don't understand, right? But never mind, this one need times and also you need focus. If long run, inshallah, you will understand, right? No problem. Okay. Let us begin with this one. I'm going to show you a simple one lah. 1x and 1y. I'm going to show you only simple one. Okay? Let's say you click analyze. Okay? You go to the regression. And then you go to the linear. Even though the simple linear regression require 1 dV and many IVs. In this example, now at 3 o'clock, I'm going to give you only 1x. Can I? Just to simulate something lah, so that you understand first. Okay, go to the linear. And then please put your job performance into the dependent. And then please put your job commitment into independent. Only job commitment only. No need to put so many. One only. Job performance as your Y and your X. Only put job commitment. Just for example only. So that you familiarize the step. And also what we are going to do now. Okay?
Job commitment is not numerical.
Sorry. Job commitment is actually numerical.
It's nominal.
Yeah. No. It's actually numerical. I wrongly put. Actually, the job commitment and tenure is scale. Yeah. Tenure. What is this?
Tenure.
Oh, okay. I call it tenure. Easy to understand. Tenure. Okay, to make this one less complicated, let us just run it, okay? But before you can run it, you cannot press any button yet because you must put something on your word. So please go to your word and behave that you are still learning, okay? Don't behave like you are so terror. Okay, so what is our step? So the first step, you must remember in any regression analysis, you are focusing now is actually SLR, simple linear regression. Two things is very important to remember. They got the descriptive and then they got the inferential. Okay, inferential. In the descriptive, they got three items or three things that you must understand. The first one is the equation. The second one is what? The second one is talking about the big R or small r. Big R. So big R stand for what? Multiple correlation. Yes, very good. Coefficient. So correlation coefficient for 1R is small capital, but big R is many lah. But in this case, we just simulate 1x first. Okay. Then number C, we talk about the coefficient of the determinant. Coefficients of determination. Coefficients of determinations is actually talking about explain variables. Explain variables. How many percentage explain variable by our X towards the Y. Okay, coefficients of determination. And then in our inferential statistic, we are going, inferential statistic is talking about what? Hypothalamus or hypothesis? Hypothesis testing, right? We want to test our assumption. What is our assumption? Actually, you got two assumptions only. The first one, to test whether your model is fit or not fit. Only this is our argument. Whether it's fit or not fit. And then the 2A also will have the 5-step hypothesis testing. You got what I mean? This one got their own 5-step. Null, alternative, alpha, okay? Kemudian, next, we are going to get the second one, the B. The B is what? Significant predictors. Significant predictors explained by your slope. What is that? Not slope. What is that? Slope. Slope. So let us begin with the 2A. What is 2A? 2A is model Model fit. Because this one is descriptive. What is meant by descriptive? You just describe, you just tell. Based on what you see, you just tell. You're not going to do any assumption, testing the assumption and whatsoever. But we want to test the assumption based on this. So, hypothesis testing will be produced. So, in the model fit, you have the step one. What is your step one? Null. What is your null? And what is your alternative? Okay, your null will be what? Model is not fit. Okay, alternative, model is fit. Ataupun, in other statistical words, that is more meaningful, you will see, there is no significant model fit observed based on the data analyzed of X and that Y, something like that. Okay, there is no significant model fit. That is the way you want to craft the words. If you're not sure, also never mind lah. You can follow the word that already give here. Regression model fit the data. This one. Okay? Because you all are so worried about my word, you follow the notes word. Regression model fits the data or regression does not fit the data. So, if you want to write it nicely, you write like this. There is no significant model fit observed in the predictive model tested for X. You name the X. Name the X. X or X's. Many X lah. Towards Y. Oh, okay. It's not mencarut, right? Oh, okay. Name of the X or X's means that so many X lah. And then your what? Your alternative will be there is significant model fit. Okay. So far, so good. Can you follow or not? There is significant model fit. Okay. I'm trying my best to explain slowly as possible so that you can understand and digest this model. Other than that, you must make revision. Okay. Step 2 is your alpha. Okay. Ikut jumhur ulama. According to the godfather of statistics, say that we need to set at minimum 0.05. And then step 3 is what? Run and calculate. Actually, you can calculate it based on the equation lah from the R. We can collect all the R and then make some calculations to produce the big R. And then after that, you need to report. What you have to report? You report two things. The R, not R. I think this one is F. F statistics and also P value. So if your F statistic is good, then you are going to say something. So step number 4 is actually decision. So decision, you got 2, P less than alpha, same also. You are going to say reject null. And then P more than alpha, you are going to, that's good. Okay, fail to reject null. And then what is your step number 5? Step 5 is conclusion. So what is your conclusion? If you reject the null, your conclusion will be? Yes. There is significant model fit. X towards Y. And then you can edit some more lah. Fail to reject null. What is your conclusion then? There is no significant model fit X towards Y. Okay, so far so good. We are going to run it slowly, one by one. We go for one by one. By right, I need to go to the next one, which is the hypothesis 2B, which is the significant predictors. But never mind, I have to pause here so that we can go one by one lah. Unless you are so clever, you want straightforward or you want to pause? Pause. Okay, pause lah.